The request library gives us a way to create and read HTTP cookies from the server. According to the MDN documentation, a cookie is a small piece of data that a server sends to the user's web browser. The cookie can be stored in the browser and it can be sent back to the server. Cookies typically serve one of three purposes: session management for login or shopping carts, user personalization, or tracking user behavior. To send and receive cookies with the request library, we will start by importing requests. Following the import, we will set a variable named URL to the string httpbin.org/cookies. We will begin using this URL because it provides us with a simple response body to see the cookie information we send to the server. Let's say that we want to customize our user experience based on a user's location. This way we can provide shipping estimates for our products without the user having to enter an address. To do this, we will request to know the user's location in the cookie, and if they agree, the information will be stored in a cookie. To mimic the content received in this event, we will declare a dictionary called cookies below our URL variable with the key of location and a value of New York. Next, we will declare a response object R and set it equal to requests.get. Within the get method, we will enter our URL variable as the first parameter followed by the cookies keyword that will be set equal to our cookies dictionary from above. Now that the request is set up, we can print the text from the response object using r.text. When the script is run, we can see the cookie we just sent is within the response body. To receive a cookie from a server, we will use a cookie that is already set up on the Google website. We will declare a second response object named r2 and set this equal to request.get. Within the get method, we will pass the string google.com. Within this request, there is a cookie already created on the Google server called 1p_jar. To access the value of this cookie, we will call the cookies function on the response object, which returns a special type of dictionary called the requestCookieJar. To access the cookie in the response body from google.com, we will use square brackets to reference the name of the cookie we would like to see. In this case, we will pass the string 1p_jar within the square brackets. When we run the script, we will see the value of the cookie printed to the console. As mentioned before, the request cookie jar is a special form of dictionary that allows us to customize where we send our cookies. To demonstrate this, we will declare a new request cookie jar named request jar and instantiate it using request.cookies.requestcookiesJar. To add a cookie to the request jar, we will use the set function. Within the set function, we will pass the name of our cookie as a string, user ID, followed by the value of our cookie as a string, John99. Using the domain and path keywords, we can decide where our new cookie information will be sent. We will set the domain keyword to httpbin.org and the path will be set to cookies. Next, we will copy and paste this line and change the cookie name to cart item with a value of laptop and a path of cart. Now we will create a get request to the same URL as before and set the cookies keyword equal to the request jar defined earlier, which now contains two cookies. When we print the value of r.text after this get request, we receive only the user ID cookie because the cart item cookie was sent to the cart path and not the cookies path, which is where we sent the get request to. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.